So for me, when my daughter was born, it was planned. And I was married at the time. It was the greatest, most amazing, most exciting thing that has ever happened to me. You know, I felt like, let's see, I was 26 when that all happened. And then the day that Emma was born, it was just amazing. I was there and I was the first one to catch her. And it was like yesterday, wow. Started this crazy adventure, right? Like when you're a dad, like when that happens, it's you can't prepare for it. I remember bringing her home, and I was the first one. She had her first poop, and it exploded all over the door. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is so cool! You know, I get to do this first thing. You know, I was excited to be a dad. And the first time that she started walking, and you know, just all those amazing little things. And then just noticed that a lot of stress started to happen in the marriage. And, you know, we were fighting. And ultimately, right before her first birthday, we ended up divorcing. And so I went from trying to see how, time myself to see how quickly I could change her diaper and trying to beat my own times to, I kept the house. And it got quiet. And I got real sad because, you know, I didn't hear her cooing or laughing, or I didn't get to play with her every single day, you know? And at night, like, I'd go and I'd lay. I would lay sometimes with her little baby, pink baby blankets and smell them. And you know, she just lived down the street, you know? But it was still, I felt like I'd been robbed, you know? And so I feel like there's this thing that wells up in a man when something like that happens. And it's, you have a choice to make. Like, what do I do now? I have this, the most amazing gift that I've ever been given that God has just like blessed me with. And now I have to make a decision. Do I fight for her? The reality of the situation is that whenever you find yourself in a situation where you have to make a choice, whether you're gonna be involved in your kid's life or not, I don't even care what situation you're in right now. I don't care how dire it is, but you have a choice to make. And this is what the choice that you make right now is gonna dictate the rest of her life. And so I had to do that. And like so many nights where you're just like, and you know, I'm not saying that it was just this beautiful thing where I'm just like, oh gosh, I choose my daughter. It's a thing to do every single day, because I know that the people that are watching this right now are gonna go through things where it's not good with your baby mama or your ex-wife or whatever it looks like. And sometimes, you know, the enemy's gonna come in and try to deter you from being involved in their life. But I'm just telling you that like through 17 years, of fighting to be in her life, I have a girl now that knows herself, that loves herself. Like, she struggles like every other teenager, but the thing is that if I go back and I look at all the times where I decided to say, yes, today I choose you, today I choose you, today I choose you, I know that in her life that this is gonna dictate what relationships look like for her also. I wasn't walking with the Lord when she was born. Like, I was a good guy, whatever. And then once I really started to know the Father's heart, which is pretty recent for me, once I started to get to know the Father's heart, that transformed everything. And now I'm able to take His heart and implant what I know about Him because of the intimacy that I've learned from Him and put it into her. And it's just an impartation of loving every single day. It doesn't matter where you're at right now. You might be watching this in a church. You might be watching this in your living room. It doesn't matter where you are. So it's a matter of surrounding yourself with godly men and women that can give you a roadmap and show you what to do.
One of the most important questions we can ask before starting anything is why. Too often, we skip asking why and jump right into doing or not doing something. So let's start there. Why legacy? When we have a million and one other things to do, Why is focusing on the legacy we'll leave worth our time? Here's why. Because legacy is the story of our lives, and your legacy can be the story you've dreamt about living, but might not believe is possible. We'll never have the life we want if we don't start by defining exactly what that life is, and then create a clear roadmap to get there. Every day, our actions are writing a page in our story. You may have heard the saying, your life is one big story filled with many chapters. But did you know we have the ability to write our stories chapter by chapter? Sure, there will be edits and rewrites as we go, and you definitely can't predict the future. However, if you don't write the story you want for your life, you're guaranteed to get an unpredictable and most likely disappointing result. So where do you start? And is it possible to create the story you want for your life when it feels like so much has already been written for you? So many mistakes or time spent doing the exact opposite of what you wish the pages of your story read? It is possible, and it starts with Jesus. God became a man and died to provide us with a new life. We were born imperfect people who needed someone to save us. Jesus did that and offers a life that's free from guilt and shame of the past. He's the only one who can take the pages already written and change them with grace, a grace we could never deserve or earn. And since we didn't earn it, we can't lose it. When I shared my story in the previous video, I mentioned that statistically, I should be in jail, doing drugs, or any other list of things working against the legacy I want to leave. But I'm not. And it's because I learned about Jesus and decided to give my life to Him. I didn't magically become perfect from that point on, but I had someone to go to in my imperfection who would forgive and welcome me as His own. Psalms 27:10 says, "Even though my father and mother walked out and left me, God took me in." I had an example to live by and hope because I made Jesus the foundation that I would build my legacy on. He adopted me as His son into His family, and now I belong to a perfect, loving Father. That's straight out of the Bible in the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 5. He made what was once impossible possible. Think about this. Everything you experience around you, houses, buildings, cars, cell phones, all of it was at one point impossible. Someone had to look at impossibility and dare to think what could be possible. And that's what Jesus wants to do with our lives. Without Him, creating a legacy worth living would be impossible. But with Him, all things are now possible. That's from the Bible too, in the book of Mark, chapter 9, verse 23. What if we started to look at everything we think is impossible and consider it as possible? How different would our days look? Well, we'd have to start by thinking differently. Instead of instinctively reacting to whatever we're facing with, it's impossible, we'd want to pause and consider how it could be possible. I want to challenge you to remove the phrase, "that's not possible," from your vocabulary and replace it with, "this is possible with Jesus." You have the opportunity to rewrite the narrative of your life, to change the story, to be a great dad. That once seemed impossible to me, but now it's my reality because anything is possible with Jesus. There are dads all over the world who are willing to say that what you are viewing as impossible is actually possible. And they are the dads taking action, doing something that everyone else thought was impossible. The more of us who think this way, the better our world will become. Jesus wants you to see your life and circumstances through the possible mindset that He's made available to you. He'll help you be the dad you were created to be. So you might be wondering, what's your next step? Well, Jesus is the next step. He died on the cross to take all the punishment for our mistakes or sins. He defeated death and rose again so we could be forgiven, adopted into His family, and live an impactful life that leaves behind a legacy of His love. Once you decide to follow Jesus, your life won't be instantly perfect, but making Jesus the foundation of your life is the first step to creating a legacy you can be proud of. So I'm going to close our conversation today with a prayer. And if you're thinking, yeah, Chris, I want all of that. I'm ready to change my mindset. I'm ready to start creating that kind of legacy and be the dad God created me to be. And you've never made the decision to live for God, or you want to re-up your commitment, all you have to do is choose to believe Jesus died and rose again to give you a life full of possibility. And pray this prayer with me. Jesus, I ask you to come live in my heart and help my life write a story that points to you. Forgive me of the mistakes in my past and give me a new purpose that comes from you. I believe that with you, every one of my impossibilities becomes possible. I pray this in your name. Amen. If you just prayed that prayer with me, congratulations. You just made the best decision of your life. Now I want you to tell someone you trust who already made the decision to follow Jesus so they can celebrate with you and help you get plugged into a Bible-believing church. Your life is never going to be the same, and that's a great thing. I'm so proud of you, and I know God is as well.